The first thing I love seeing when a game starts, why am I against Challenger and Master? Alright, so I'll show you guys my pathing against Elisen, aka Excessive Force in the early game. I might look for an invid. It's risky though, like I don't mind losing my first red buff as long as I can get 5 out of 6 gamps, then it's fine. Yeah, this does put my red buff at risk, so. So I'm gonna hold my smite for raptors. I'm gonna use my potions. I mean, it's not really gankable now, so I'm gonna push Luxa in the entire lane phase. Top should be gankable, but this guy's pretty stupid, so I don't really trust him. Basically, I just want to full clear on my first rotation. And hopefully Sin fails ganks, that's pretty much how it's gonna be. He started blue though, so he's either gonna path bot side or mid. I'll hold my second point in Q in case I come across him in my jungle. Just for an extra escape pattern. I was fine with losing red buff, but I lost Crux too, so I'm actually behind now. Right, so he has 16 CS, that means he took Wolves, Gromp, his blue, my red, and Krugs, and I think Scuttle too maybe, I don't know. That's the problem with this pathing early game. You're pretty much hoping he ganks the lane so you can get ahead from it. But now his bot side's exposed, and now I'm getting- this is why I don't like streaming, man. Like, how the fuck can this guy know that I'm here? That is stupid. Unless it's warded. I don't think that's worded. Because I walked through here. Whatever, man. I mean, his pathing on Lee Sin wasn't really something that happens often, so that's why I'm kind of surprised. Usually you just take this, and then invade top, but he took, like, everything and then still went top, so. Kind of surprising to me. Hecarim is not a bad matchup in Elisen either, just like he knows when all my camps are up for some reason, and that reason is kind of obvious because I'm streaming, so. But, like, whatever, dude. Like, if I were to make a move for his red right now, I'd probably get 3-manned. There isn't a doubt in my mind. Oh, they're fucking stupid. I guess they can't 2v1 me when they're dead, so I gotta use that to my advantage. Knowing Lux is just gonna follow me everywhere I go. Pishin is fucking Lux versus Malzahar. This is somehow worded. I'll take her word on it, whatever. Okay, invading bot side again, let's see. Like, this should be hit for some vision. Dragon or bot side if he's walking towards this. Okay, he's bot side right now. In my jungle. It's just so easy to read where they're going through their body language. We just pretty much go through process of elimination. If he's walking here, it's either to go for dragon or my bot side. Or to camp here for bot lane. There's like three possible outcomes. At least I show you guys like the worst possible early game you can have and how to come back from it. Yeah, we gave up a few kills bot, but like, only Lee Sin got every kill, so it's really not an issue. So now he pushed top, which means he's gonna move to my red right about now. Or he's gonna keep pushing. Two possible outcomes again. I think I can 2v1 that easily. But he has armor. That was lucky, kind of. I ulted Vlad before he can get his ult off. So he was feared and couldn't do anything. That was kind of a 50-50 though. Like, whoever ults first wins, pretty much. And this pink is useless, so I'll just buy another one. 75 gold isn't too much of a hassle. Rather have an entrance covered rather than nothing. And now since we're like more ahead, I can place pink wards in their jungle rather than my jungle, because Lee Sin can't evade anymore. Malzahar is gonna push this lane, wave. I can make a move there. This is a really good place to have a pink ward down, by the way. We've gotten every outer turret, so this is our prime opportunity to group his 5 and dive a lane while they're like pushing an outer lane. But this is a solo queue, so I don't think it's gonna happen. But in competitive, this is what would happen. When they have 0 turrets down and we have 3 outers, then someone's gonna be in this lane or this lane of push, and we could like dive the opposite lane. Like mid lane dive would be pretty good here too. You don't have much wave clear without Lux ulti. Don't forget this guy. Oh no. That was close. I held on to my ulti to escape or to like get a kill on Lux. Wasn't expecting her to live, but she did, so I had to ult her. And with Trinity, it just gave me a lot of movement speed to get out of the situation. So now that they have pressure and we're all recalling, I can't invade their blue. I'll just go for my blue instead. It would be nice to get their blue out of the way, but it's safer to go for my blue. It is easily diveable with no summoners. Like, I can just literally walk behind her and get a kill. I don't care about like, what I want to kill him. Thank god. He didn't use exhaust last fight, which is my mistake, but we get mid turret out of it because he sent 4 people on me. So they don't need me for dragon, I can go pressure topside. I don't know why they're stacking Tabi. Because Malzahar can just CC them and they'll die. His lantern's down, I can just go in. So the only reason we could have dove there was because we saw them all go topside. And we know this guy has no summoners. Also, Jhin flashed, I think. Wasn't really paying attention. So that's just basically going off the information that's presented by the enemy team. Them showing their champion icons topside means that mid is easy to dive. And now while like my team's recuperating and like recalling for gold and items, then I can just clear my jungle for an advantage on enemy jungler. I have 2 levels on him. Could be better, but I'll take it. And when you're ahead by this much, you want to contest every single buff. I need exhaust this, I'll just back up for now. I don't know if you got exhausted. Yeah, that's why Tabwise aren't good against our team. Notice how I like go behind him rather than just being into him so I can push him into our team. That's something you can use for your ganks as well. Like expecting a flash and then, yeah. Hit the fucking. Oh my god. Anyways. That was a good game to showcase, so like, I got completely smashed early game, and they managed to come back through like giving up camps at least. And you have to know when you can sacrifice as a jungler.